Now, let me give you a snapshot on the on Afghanistan. Right now, Afghanistan is facing serious security challenges. There are many challenges, but we are going to take five major challenges which Afghanistan is facing right now. Okay, before we start this, agar aapka koi question hai, Aruj, to please you can ask.
Sir, no, I think we are going fine.
Okay,
ठीक
I hope you are not getting bored. क्योंकि मैं जब
नहीं
शुरू
सर,
हो जाता हूँ
सर आई वुड लाइक टू, अगर आप मुझे थोड़ा सा अफगानिस्तान का जो मैप आप कल भी बात कर रहे थे, अगर आप थोड़ा सा उससे रेफरेंस से बात अगर मुझे कर लें तो दैट वुड बी परफेक्ट.
श्योर. अच्छा, अभी मैं डिस्कस करता हूँ ये सारा. ओके, सो अफगानिस्तान इज एक्चुअली फेसिंग सीरियस प्रॉब्लम्स नाउ. 19 इयर्स हैव बीन यू नो पास्ट एंड अमेरिकन्स दे कुड नॉट अचीव देयर स्टेटेड गोल्स इन अफगानिस्तान. Right now, the situation in Afghanistan is worse, and Afghanistan is primarily facing five major challenges. And because of these five challenges, the other problems are also, you know, there. The first major challenge is from resurgent Afghan Taliban. In 2001, when the United States of America, you know, kicked out Afghan Taliban from Afghanistan, at that time, Afghan Taliban had a number of about 42,000. Today, in modern times, Afghan Taliban, they are now more than 65,000. They are 60,000 plus. At the same time, they are also having, you know, alliance with the Haqqani network, which who are almost 4,000 plus, and they are also having alliance with the Al-Qaeda. They are also 100 plus. So basically, Afghan Taliban, they are much stronger than the past. In 2001, they had only support from Pakistan, UAE and Saudi Arabia. Today, the Afghan Taliban, they have support of Pakistan, Iran, China, Russia, US, NATO. They also support now because they recently carried out a peace agreement with Taliban. So today's Taliban, they are much, much stronger than the previous one. Today's Taliban, they have got, you know, about $2 billion of assets, which are enough to run, you know, their organization. Secondly, they can prolong this war for many years if they want. They are highly organized. Now, from the local level to the upper level, they are highly organized, and they have got their own, you know, Tanzim. They are highly motivated. They believe that they have, you know, defeated America, United States of America, along with 49 countries, NATO, and they are, you know, highly motivated, which, you know, motivate them to be aggressive there in Afghanistan. They are robust. They have formed. They have, you know, they reorganized themselves, and they have introduced special forces in their ranks, which is, you know, that special forces are, you know, consist of different, you know, highly trained guerrillas along with suicide bombers, and they carry out attacks swiftly and quickly, and Afghan forces are unable to defeat them. And of course, they are well equipped. They have got enough weapons in Afghanistan, and Afghanistan never faced, you know, dearth of weapons. It's huge. So Afghan Taliban, they are the major challenge to the Afghan security forces and Afghanistan, of course, and the Afghan government is unable to defeat them. Most of the parts in Afghanistan, they are under the shadow government of Afghan Taliban. Like, for example, the Afghan government is also controlling those areas. And the Afghan Taliban, they also have got their own policing. They also got their own justice system. Another major challenge to Afghanistan is the ISKP. ISKP, as I told you before, this is Islamic State Khorasan province. They are the offshoot of, you know, a terrorist organization which is there in Middle East, Iraq and Syria, the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. So that particular organization has an offshoot in Afghanistan, the with the name ISKP. They are, you know, they consist of locals, especially they are Pakistanis, they are Uzbeks, and they are also Afghans, but they are locals. Initially, they were centered in Pakistani, you know, in Afghanistan's Nangarhar province. As you can see on the map, they were centered there, and their number was close to 4,000 after 2015. Acha, ye kaise hua sara? Hua ye ki after 2015, Pakistan conducted Operation Zarbe Azab, and we, you know, pushed all sorts of militants like TTP and others. They were defeated in Pakistan. So Pakistan pushed them to Afghanistan. So when Pakistan pushed them to Afghanistan, they were jobless. So they opened another, you know, you can say business there, and they became ISKP. So the people in IS ranks, ISKP ranks, they were former TTP people. Like, for example, Amir Orakzai, Saeed Khan, who was the first commander of Amir of ISKP. He was from Orakzai Agency, and he was the TTP's commander in Orakzai Agency. The other person was Shahidullah Shahid, who was the former spokesperson of TTP. So basically, they are the locals, and they also had support of Tajik and Uzbeks and others. So ISKP initially had 4,000 members, but ISKP faced three-pronged challenge in Afghanistan. Why? Because they were facing Afghan Taliban, they were facing Afghan security forces, and they were facing the American forces. So Afghan Taliban believe that Afghanistan is their playground, and they will never allow ISIS, you know, type of groups to flourish in Afghanistan. So they conducted many military operations against ISKP in Afghanistan, and they killed, you know, hundreds of ISKP members. The Afghan security forces, they might be weaker against Afghan Taliban, but they are quite, you know, efficient against ISKP. So they also conducted many operations against them, and they also killed a number of people. The Americans, of course, the Americans are about 4,800, you know, but they are highly well equipped. They possess, you know, aircraft. They possess, you know, strong military and strong air muscle, drone strike, you know, and other things. The Americans conducted drone strikes, accurate drone strikes, and they killed ISKP senior leadership like Saeed Khan, Abdul Rauf. Saeed Khan was their emir, and Abdul Rauf was recruiting for them, and they were killed in American drone strikes. Other than that, America also dropped the mother of all bombs, MOAB, which is the, you know, largest, you can say, conventional bomb in the American inventory, and it was first time ever it was used on ISKP in Achin district of Nangarhar in Afghanistan. So despite all these things, the ISKP is still a threat to Afghanistan, and they are still a threat to Pakistan, and they have been able to conduct, you know, high profile attacks in Pakistan and Afghanistan, and bas chal raha hai abhi bhi. But they are not that strong. Afghanistan, Afghan Taliban ki tarah, they are not strong. They can't control Afghanistan, but they can disrupt peace and security in the region. Third major challenge to Afghanistan security is fragile Afghan national security forces. America planned a huge force for Afghanistan when they came to Afghanistan. They planned about 352,000 strong force for Afghanistan. And they spent billions of dollars. Like, for example, they spent more than $68 billion on the refurbishment, on the improvement of Afghan security forces, on the training of Afghan security forces, on the weapon and equipment purchases of the Afghan security forces. But despite spending, you know, huge money, close to $70 billion, they are unable to make a strong professional force in Afghanistan. There had been, you know, many, many green on blue attacks. Now, what are green on blue attacks? Green on blue attacks means when Afghan security forces personnel, they kill their own commanders. So this has been there, and they killed many high profile commanders. The Afghan security forces, the Taliban, they penetrated the ranks, and they were able to carry out these assassinations. So Afghan national security forces, they are unable to cope up with the Afghanistan's challenge, and the reason is simple. Afghanistan is too big country. It's about 652,000 square kilometer area, and it's a big country. It is close to Pakistan. At the same time, they have got, you know, army of about 100 and you know, less than 200,000. Okay, according to counterinsurgency experts like Syed Jones, he says that if you want to eradicate terrorism, you have to deploy five soldiers for one guerrilla, one terrorist. Now, if you take that ratio, Afghanistan is short of, you know, 200,000 troops. According to Syed Jones, if you want to establish peace in Afghanistan, you have to deploy 300 to 400,000 well-equipped, highly motivated troops. and highly trained troops. But the Afghan security forces, they are not highly trained. They are a new force and they need time to learn. So this is the reason that they are unable to, you know, establish peace in tribal areas of, in Afghanistan. Now, why we got success in Pakistani tribal areas? The stats are simple. Pakistani tribal areas, these areas are 12 times smaller than Afghanistan. Now, these areas are just, 27,000 square kilometer, where Pakistan has deployed more than 200,000 troops. Ab aap khud andaza lagayein ki unhone itne bade area pe 2 lakh fauj rakhi aur aapne sirf chote se area pe 2 lakh fauj rakhi. So this is the difference. We deployed more than 200,000 troops against, I think, 15 or 20,000 militants. So this was the reason that we deployed adequate troops according to counterinsurgency rules, which proved to be successful. And Pakistan, alhamdulillah, conducted high profile, zabardast kism ki operations, and we established peace in our areas. And Afghanistan is still facing problems. So this is the basic difference. Now, the fourth major challenge which Afghanistan is facing, the India-Pakistan-Afghanistan's discord, their proxy wars. These three countries, they are up against each other. And they carry out, proxy war against each other. As I told you, I think before, that why India is there in Afghanistan? India is there in Afghanistan for primarily two reasons. One, economic, and other, strategic. Economic. Why they are there, in Afghanistan? They want to, grab iron reserves in Afghanistan, which are, located in Hajigak area, Bamiyan province. And those iron reserves worth of about $420 billion. It's a huge, huge, huge money. They want to take these resources. And this is the reason they are there. They have also carried out many, soft image, type of projects in which they build some Parliament of India, Afghanistan, and the Salma Dam project. And they build some roads and, infrastructure. So in return, they wanted to get, hold on the iron reserves in Afghanistan. Secondly, they are also involved in, they are also part, part of TAPI, which is the Turkmenistan-Afghanistan-India pipeline. And this pipeline is going to originate from Turkmenistan. They are going to enter Afghanistan and then Pakistan and then India. So they are also part of this particular pipeline. So if they are there in Afghanistan, so they can protect their interest in Afghanistan. So these are their economic interests. But let me tell you, how they are going to transport the iron reserves from Afghanistan. The shortest route is through Pakistan, which is 900 kilometers. Bamiyan to Pakistan, Pakistan to Wagha border. This is the shortest route, land route. But Pakistan is not allowing India to take these, these resources. So what is the other option? The other option is a railway line, which India is planning with Iran and Afghanistan. And this railway line is going to take place will start from Bamiyan, Hajigak, and it is going to connect Zaranj, which is the Iranian area. And from Zaranj, they are going to connect this with Chabahar. And from Chabahar, they are going to take these resources to Mumbai. Now, this whole area, if you estimate it, maine iska Google map pe nikal ke dekha, to it was about 3500 kilometers, more than 3500 kilometers. Aur Pakistan ke zariye se kitna tha? It was only 900 kilometers. So this is the difference. You cannot ignore Pakistan. You just can't shrug off Pakistan. So this is the reason that India is facing serious problems. अच्छा ये तो हो गया इंडिया की अपनी एक ये मैंने आउट ऑफ द वे आपको समझाया दूसरी जो इंपॉर्टेंट चीज थी इंडिया इज देयर इन अफगानिस्तान फॉर स्ट्रेटजिक पर्पसेस व्हाट इज देयर स्ट्रेटजिक पर्पसेस स्ट्रेटजिक पर्पसेस टू क्रिएट पाकिस्तान सिक्योरिटी टू अंडरमाइन पाकिस्तान सिक्योरिटी सिंपल एंड हाउ दे आर गोइंग टू डू इट दे आर गोइंग टू डू इट थ्रू हाइब्रिड वॉरफेयर थ्रू यूज ऑफ टेररिज्म प्रॉक्सी वॉर नाउ लेट मी गिव यू एन एग्जांपल ऑफ लतीफ महसूद नाउ दिस पर्सन he was the second in command of, TTP. And his name is Latif Mahsood. He's now under the custody of Pakistan. But he was there in Afghanistan in 2012. And he was in meeting with RAW, Indian Intelligence, and Afghanistan's intelligence, and he was there to arrange finances for TTP. At that time, he was captured by NATO. And why NATO captured him, and they later on handed over to Pakistan? Because NATO also wanted to settle their issue, and they knew that only Pakistan can help them. Pakistan is the only country which can help them to bring Taliban on the board, on the table. So Pakistan, NATO gave this person to Pakistan. And when he came to Pakistan, and he gave a confession, video in which he declared that India and Afghanistan both are creating terrorism in Pakistan. So this was the Indian strategy which they employed applied against Pakistan. Secondly, the Ehsanullah Hassan, who is the commander of TTP, also he also surrendered, and he also gave an interview in which he accepted that yes, India has been funding TTP and other terrorist organizations. And ultimately, Kulbhushan Yadav, who was captured, nabbed in Balochistan, and in his confessional video, he accepted all these allegations, and he said, "Yes, we have been supporting militants in Balochistan and Fatah," and of course, he was also carrying out terrorism in Karachi, and the idea was just to disrupt CPAC. So this is the hybrid warfare which the Indians have been. Had been applying against Pakistan. And ultimately, America's former Secretary of Defense, Jack Hagel, he also, in 2013, he also said that India is, financing problems from Afghanistan against Pakistan. So this is something which is there. And the Indians, they have been, doing all these things against Pakistan. And Afghanistan is, with them. So the Afghan,
I
India,
want to
yes.
ask you over here. You have used the term of hybrid warfare. Can you elaborate that term, please?
Yes, hybrid warfare is a kind of warfare which is not new, in which you use, propaganda, in which you use terrorism, proxy war, offensive diplomacy. Sometimes you carry out surgical strikes, sometimes you carry out war, sometimes you use special forces, sometimes you use propaganda, sometimes you try to isolate Pakistan at regional and global level by, boycotting SAARC and trying to defame Pakistan at international level. So it's a kind of strategy in which your enemy employs, different kinds of things. जो मैंने आपको बताई अभी, he जो आपका दुश्मन है, they use, terrorism, proxy war, propaganda, psychological warfare. Sometimes they carry out surgical strikes. Sometimes they, I try to isolate you diplomatically at global level. So it's a basically a mixture of different warfare.